Coming to you from Homebrew Studios, it's Bob and John's Super Duper Variety Power Hour with your hosts, Bob Cady
and John Piccirillo
and Jay Schmidt.
Welcome to Bob and John's Super Duper Variety Power Hour, episode 80.
Welcome aboard, folks.
Hi.
Hi.
You know how I like to make notes? So I remember things?
Tell us, John.
So later on, maybe I'll show you.
Excuse me while I whip this out.
I'll show you my first attempt at the talent symbol.
Talent symbol. Yeah. And you know what? Seeing that we did the quick shots before this, they're going to be in
nobody's going to know what we're talking nobody's about. Nobody's going to know. So let's not.
You're going to have to watch the quick shots next week to understand what this really means.
Right. Exactly.
You'll figure it out.
Yep.
Stand by.
I can tell you it means talent. See, that's what's a down bummer is. We can't keep the roll going, you know, like we'll forget about it by the next time and it'll be lost forever. But right now it's like monumental.
It usually is monumental in the moment, but do you think I've forgotten about the pretzel peddler from the last podcast? Are you kidding me?
I've never heard you laugh that hard either.
Oh my God. That was awesome. That was funnier than shit.
You were hurting. Written unit.
That was great.
That was good.
Oh, I just found on the break, too, the new iPhone. I can scan the barcode for Untapped, which is very exciting because searching has been a challenge. The more.
Yeah, that's awesome. That's a good.
The stranger feature. The beer,
maybe you need to get a scanner app, and then maybe it'll
actually. I have one on there.
Oh, you do?
Yeah, I think it's because the phone's so old. It's almost 3 years old. So.
Yeah,
you were calling mine old, and it was not even two yet.
I'm due for a new one soon. So
yours is well.
And that's what I was saying to John. They just updated the software on it, and now killed my freaking battery. I think they do that on purpose.
They kill your battery with it?
They just update this. They update the software, and it's like now my battery's shit.
Yeah, it's probably working twice as hard to do all this stuff.
Hold up. Yeah,
it doesn't hold up at all. And they say it's supposed to save your battery. I'm like, it didn't save nothing. It kills it now. From where it used to last 2 days, now it lasts.
Yeah, hours. 2 years is like I feel like if you have a piece of technology for 2 years now, you're past its prime.
Well, I got roped into the 3 year thing, so I'm stuck with it for another 6 months or so.
AT&T doesn't have that anymore. They don't even have contracts anymore. They just have.
I could pay more and go get a new phone, but I don't want to. I'm paying per month on the phone,
especially when it works.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, so you know what? I'm going to fix this note then.
Anywho.
So the quick shots was about thunder, lightning, and talent.
What an asshole!
See, instead of a stick figure, I'm going to use.
You're goddamn right I do. So here come two words for you. Shut the fuck up.
A chicken.
There, that looks a little better, right?
Looks like a chicken.
Yeah, it does look like a chicken.
Just moron number one? Put moron number two on the phone.
Looks like three penises.
My God.
I can't make a hand.
When I say the name, Dickus. Dickus. When I say the name, Dickus, Dickus.
They must have had a mic like right here to pick all that up.
Well, the guy was like losing his.
It's from a movie, that's what. Yeah,
yeah.
I know.
He was going.
Yeah, Yeah, I know.
Trying to hold it in.
But to get all the little squeaks and stuff, you got to have a mic.
You do those condenser mics. You know what I mean? Like those look at those condenser mics. You can't see it, everybody, because it's behind you. But the condenser mics that hang over your drum set.
Yep.
You can pick up these aren't condenser mics, so you don't pick up every little nuance.
When I say the name, because. Biggus.
Biggus.
What was that movie?
Life of Brian.
Life of Brian. Monty Python.
I don't know that.
Which one. I didn't see till recently, and that was freaking funny.
Was it?
Yeah.
Oh, there's a lot of funny parts in that.
I'll have to really check it out.
The meaning of life and the life of Brian.
Took me a long time to see meaning of life.
There's more hit and miss than say like the Holy Grail, you know. Right.
Yeah,
obviously the Holy Grail is the, you know, is like their
the Holy Grail.
The Holy Grail of Monty Python movies.
I'm like a rattler.
What an asshole!
That's talent.
We need a little thing down here. Please see quick shots next week for meaning.
All right, you primitive screwheads, listen up.
Time to make the chimmy fucking changas.
You can find us at Bob and John's podcast at gmail.com, on iTunes and Buzzsprout.com, or
at Loose and Buttery on the Twitter and Instagram or Periscope.
And on our YouTube channel and our Facebook page, Bob and John's Super Duper Variety Power Hour. And also on Untapped at Jay's Brew and Brewmaster Pick with 2 C's.
When I say the name, Bigus. Bigus.
When I say the name, Bigus.
Yeah, I put definition with it down there on the bottom, so that way the drawings aren't helping. The drawings aren't helping me. Yeah, I can double check and remember that.
So exactly. When they come across the time capsule,
right? Exactly.
50 years.
Yeah. means- exactly.
You got like Cat in the Hat fingers.
Right? I know. Like
Dr. Seuss. Yeah, does it looks like
green eggs and ham? I am.
You are.
Two in the can.
Two in the can.
Come in the pink.
Two in the can, I am.
Talent.
When I...
What an asshole!
Oh, Jesus.
All right. Now we're back in order here.
You feeling good now?
Yeah. I got all my notes.
19 more episodes after this one until Big 100.
That's right. We're going to... Wow. Gonna kick it up a notch.
Yeah, you wait. Stay tuned.
We're gonna have talent.
What an asshole!
John's gonna pull out the pretzel peddler.
Yes.
Well, I have been shopping for
Lederhosen
Halloween. That is not on my cart at Amazon yet. I'm going to have to get that a whirl. Yeah, I got to see if...
Oh, there he goes.
Does anybody know how to spell a Lederhosen?
Well,
L.
Lederhosen or a Lederhosen?
I imagine it's a whole getup, you know? I don't know if Amazon's going to do that.
I don't know.
What do you mean? You didn't start shopping for you want me to wear it so bad. I thought you were on it.
You're the costume boy.
I've seen those costumes. They do have them.
Yeah, you're Mr. Costume.
L-E-E-D?
No, I think it's either L-E-I or L-I-E, one or the other.
Lederhosen.
Lederhosen. Oh, yeah, baby.
You find them?
No problemo. Oh, shit. I can have a killer one for under $100.
Oh, there we go. Come on.
Anything
we have
that's
to get
not
it.
Three digits, I'm down.
Petzl Predler.
The girl ones looks way good, though.
So the girl or the Lederhosen?
Both. So this one comes into just under 100, and it looks like a pro deal.
All right. Well, I think you need to get it. Pro
Lederhosen.
Pro Lederhosen.
Yeah. Yeah. Nice. Those are, that's it.
That's nice.
Wow. That's serious.
Yeah. Lederhosen.
Yeah. I think you need to get that.
It is pretty good. Would I wear the shirt or would I be? I was kind of picturing the outfit without a shirt.
Yes. Without a shirt. Absolutely. But with the bow tie. No shirt, bow tie, Lederhosen.
Okay. I can go Harry Quadracci.
Flip flops and the little German hat.
Oh, I'm down. I'm down. I'm seeing it all paint. It's all.
The problem was last week I did see it. That's why I was laughing so hard.
I know. Now I'm having a whole epiphany.
Epiphany?
Epiphany. I could get the shirt. Look, there's a.
No shirt.
Lederhosen shirt.
It's a Lederhosen
shirt. I've seen those before too. Yeah, they're good too. That's a good one. Actually.
Yeah, it's a good one.
You got to have
Bob
the real Lederhosen.
Bob wants to see my nipples. Well, the Lederhosen covers it though. That they have their little belt.
That
thing.
Sounds like a hot item.
Well, that is a hot item, Bob.
What were you talking about before the show? For some reason, hippies make you think of pinching nipples.
Oh, yeah, I don't know. I don't know what it is. When I just think of like hippies dancing around and stuff, the first thing that comes to my mind is like la 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 in a circle. Like I don't know why.
Were you around nipple pinching hippies?
I have no idea where this obsession came from, but that's yeah, I totally think that. Actually,
can you see him doing the German music with the Lederhosen with no shirt on the bow tie going like this with pinching the
Maybe I could get tassels.
Get a little beanie on your head with the with the helicopter
early bird.
Yeah, the real
this is gonna be that's gonna be some incredible outfit.
Yeah, the real high quality ones are still under $100. I'd like to get some nice leather Lederhosen, you know what I'm saying? Follow what I'm saying? See, everybody thinks it's a no brainer, so just get Lederhosen. Well, guess what? I still want assless chaps. You know what I mean? I want stilts, the kind you can run in, not just
priorities.
Yeah, exactly. I gotta arrange these things.
I know, but we gotta jump on the Lederhosen because
they're
cheaper.
You want
when
it
it's
so
hot.
Bad, you should buy it as a gift for me.
At least
for
not jumping
that
on the assless chaps.
Because I think I could get a lot of use. I'm thinking of all the uses I could get out of assless chaps. You know, I can definitely get away with that. It would be good for motorcycle
if
riding.
You're going to get the assless chaps, get the ponytail thing like David Lee Roth used to wear.
Sure. Assless chaps. It's like a lifelong dream.
Are they on Amazon?
Hey, let's go. Let's look.
I guarantee they probably do. It's Amazon. They have everything.
That's why I've been digging it. Because I keep getting credits, but that's the bad thing, though. If it's Prime, you get it delivered quickly, cheaply, right? Isn't that the idea?
Free, yeah.
So I think I've been skipping it, even if it's Prime, because I don't care. And then I get fucked. It takes a month to deliver.
No, they'll automatically. Well, you should be able to pick it.
They've been giving me credit, is what they've been getting, because I'm not asking to rush it. Because I'm in no rush. So there's like, well, you have a $5.99 credit to your account or something like that.
I've never run into that. So
it's been happening to me.
Oh, I never run into that.
Do you think Amazon calls them assless chaps?
I don't know.
Yes, they do. They
yes,
do.
They do.
Yep. Wow, hey. Those are pretty cheap, too.
Talent.
There is.
What an asshole!
Oh, my. There's more than just that, too. I could get the Tyrain Men Sexy Wrestling Singlet Faux Leather Underwear Lingerie Bodysuit Pant.
I think you need to get something every single week to fucking dress up.
I know. Oh, why haven't you
done the loincloth yet? I'm still wondering why.
I have it.
Well, why aren't you dressed in it?
Oh, I keep forgetting to bring it.
Oh.
It's in the wash.
It's in the wash.
It got used this weekend, and it really needed to be laundered.
I was alone at camp.
Oh.
I'm touching myself tonight.
And you know, it gets a little crazy when
he's alone out there. Gets a little crazy. The loincloth comes
all
out.
All alone.
He's soiled.
When I say the name
Dickus.
Dickus.
Dickus. Dickus. Is that your name when you put the loincloth on?
Dickus.
Biggest Dickus.
Biggest Dickus.
Excuse me while I whip this out.
Biggest Dickus.
Classic biker leather chaps. Yep, that's what I'm talking about right there.
When you wear the assless chaps,
oh, that's
if weird. I were you, I
by
would,
the way,
I would kind of
too. So
I would kind of Jesus,
right? That's a that's like
oh
that's,
wow,
yeah. You know what I'm saying? Yep, yeah,
you might want to have a little bit of a cod piece with that.
Yes, I need a cod piece, like jean.
When you wear that getup, you might want to, you know, be a little bit aware of which bars you go to.
Oh, I know. I know. Yeah, yeah. I'm going to back out of this page quickly.
No pun intended. Talent.
What an asshole!
That's what they'd be saying if you were at the bar.
Get the chaps on.
Look
that.
At the talent!
Look at that guy. All right, enough shopping.
I'll put this forth. The only gay bar I was ever in was with John.
It wasn't my fault.
It wasn't my fault.
I didn't know anything about it. Nothing. Actually, I don't think I even knew when I went.
It was Julie that reined us into that.
Oh, I thought you were talking about a different one. Cause,
wait, hey, I've only been in the one that I got roped into. So you got more? You got multiple stories?
That was... It was the big one right down by my house.
Next to the sawmill, that one.
Yeah, right over by the sawmill.
Oh, hold it. It's going to come to me.
You know who brought me.
Tim.
Yeah, we didn't know how that happened.
The Blythewood or something?
Oh, the Blythewood.
Yeah, that was it. Yeah,
I'm trying to think on the name.
Yep. I went in there, and he didn't tell me till afterwards.
That's
he
the
was
one
laughing when we left, and I'm like, what's so funny? He's like,
that's a gay bar.
He knew the bartender or something. That's why.
Nice of you to tell me now.
That's the one he brought.
I'm glad my natural instincts took over, you know what I mean?
He brought Jeff. He brought Jeff and Wendy. And is that the one where Jeff put the quarter down on the table and like all the
running a whole bunch of boys came over and put quarters down. This is funny.
The one we went to.
He was like
the one Julie took us to. We went to dinner with Julie at the.
See, now that was already headed more to like LGBT, you know what I mean? Like the Blythewood was gay.
old school.
Yeah, it was men that were gay. I don't remember seeing a girl in there. I think we went to a place where like,
well, there was
homosexual, there was lesbians,
yeah, you know, which I mean? Really was quite utterly confusing.
Well,
because
it's confusing to a straight man, yeah, a little bit.
Well, yeah, because you go in there and you're looking at women and they're they're giving you more than normal. Like normally you go into a bar and as a guy,
confusing.
You look at a woman and they give
really
you a look
confusing.
Like, what the fuck are you looking at?
Yeah.
But this one is really like, what the fuck? You know?
You're looking at me. I don't dig dick at all, but that's kind of fun.
And then when you're in a bar,
yeah,
when you're in a, I don't know, a regular bar with heterosexual people in it. When you have a thing, you make eye contact with other guys when you're scanning the crowd or something. You know what I mean?
Yeah, yeah.
That's a whole different meaning when you're in a gay bar and you're. No, it's not panic, but it's like, no, you know, it's more of, no, sorry, I didn't mean, I'm not putting that out there. I'm okay. Yeah. It's okay. You,
like, in
we're good.
We were used to is like, the feeling was, okay, all right.
We were there because Julie's boss was gay.
Yeah.
And she was over there, so we went over there. No, and it wasn't like anything, I didn't feel like threatened or anything.
No.
Well, there was that very large cross dresser in the red dress that was very.
There's always a bad apple.
I didn't say it was a bad apple, but it was, put it this way, we're pretty big guys,
yeah.
But this guy was big guy, like I'm like Yeah. That would have been intimidating and afraid for my
big, giant
sphincter.
Intimidating
talents.
talents. Yeah, that you really don't know what their intentions are. You know what I mean? Yeah, I have no idea.
Oh, anyway, so we go on the way out. We're leaving and come up to the door, and he opens the door for me to go out. And when I start walking out, he fucking grabs my ass on the way out.
I was catching the fever.
What fever?
The everybody love.
Why do you want that?
Everybody love one another.
Because he's thirsty, dummy. Hold it.
No. Do you mean the hippie vibe?
I got to get tassels. This means happy. This is the new sign language. That's what Bob and John signed language. This means happy. This is talent.
Oh, you blew it now. We were going to make him guess, but not.
What an asshole!
Untapped actually has a new badge for drinking in a gay bar.
Really?
You have to do five, though.
What?
You have to do five gay bars, five drinks in a gay bar.
Untapped?
Untapped.
I'm pissed I didn't get my early morning one for golfing. I didn't get anything special for the early morning one.
They you have to do more than one.
Oh, yeah. I didn't know. Oh, it's because you do it every week.
Yes.
Forgot that little thing.
All right, you primitive screwheads, listen up.
Time to make the chimmy fucking changas.
You can find us at bobandjohnspodcast@gmail.com, on iTunes and buzzsprout.com, or
at Loose and Buttery on the Twitter and Instagram or Periscope.
And on our YouTube channel and our Facebook page at Bob and John's Super Duper Variety Power Hour. And also on Untapped at Jay's Brew and Brewmaster Pick, 2 C's.
When I say the name, because.
Chillin' with Jay's Brew. Chillin' with Jay's Brew. Chillin' with Jay's Brew.
Jay's got a story.
Oh, I got a lot to talk about.
Oh, this is a 2-hour podcast.
No. Not that much. I'll make it quick.
Oh, don't make it quick.
I went back.
John likes talent.
That's right. I like talent. Woo! I like those too.
Back to Wolf Hollow again.
Woo! That's something I also said to Mike McMullen, not to cut you off.
Yeah.
I said,
you are.
Go to Wolf's Hollow and grab yourself a growler and let me know if I know a thing or two about beer.
Yes.
All right. I'm sorry to interrupt.
That's okay. And hopefully we can get a picture of this. Maybe put this up behind there. But
are those new ones?
Those are new ones. That's that I took.
Ales for owls.
Ales for ALS. They had a
owls.
They had a charity event actually Sunday. They were open, but it was only to Wolfpack members.
Yep. Hey, that's something I want them to do.
And this was a kind of kind of a special thing. They're doing a they're participating in this Ales for ALS, which is Lou Gehrig's disease.
Mm-hmm.
So they have.
He didn't even see it coming.
Yeah, they are part of this. What happens is this Ales for ALS .com sends them a bunch of hops.
Mm-hmm.
They don't know what type of hops, so they have to brew a beer with it. And then proceeds of they're donating a dollar a pint back to ALS research.
Oh,
Wolf Hollow. There's 9 breweries in New York that are doing it. If you go on alesforals.com, they'll tell you.
We should take a picture of that, Bob.
Yeah, it's what's hoping maybe we can put that
up behind
us. I'm going
to take a picture of that, John.
Well, I don't want to use it for beer if we're going to. We need at least one.
Yeah, that's what. Yeah, yeah. That's why I brought them. But anyway, on Sunday.
Hang on a second. I'll read this.
Yeah.
Ales for ALS. It may seem like just another beer, but your purchase of Ales for ALS brew supports research towards treatment of ALS, Lou Gehrig's disease. You're a bit of a rock star, and you should let the world know. Take a selfie with the brew and share using hashtag ALS. No, ALS for ALS. You could be featured on the Ales for ALS Instagram page. Thanks. You're amazing. Thank you.
But yeah, they're on Facebook and on Instagram, Ales for ALS, and
www.alesforals.com. That's another titty twister.
Yeah. It's
Ales, ALESFORALS.com.
Yes.
And this is also, I think, for the Instagram, would it be pound?
Pound.
ALESFORALS. Yes. L's for ALS.
You know, and I don't, most of my charity stuff, I do golf tournaments and stuff like that for charity stuff. That's my kind of thing. And this, I mean, I thought I could do something by drinking. So
we went. Count me in.
We went Sunday and drank a bunch because they,
How long is it going?
We'll follow. Well, this isn't even out yet. This is a pre-release of their new beer that I have brought.
So
tonight.
We don't even know what the hops are?
No, Ales for ALS sent them hops because they're participating in the program. So they've...
We're not used to movement down here behind us. It's okay. Everything will be fine. Everything will be fine.
Are you painting or something?
Yeah. Oh, boy.
Painting? Finger painting?
What an asshole!
So that's the one. That's the one that they donated the hops.
This is the beer that was donated. The hops were donated by Ales for ALS to Wolf Hollow Brewing. They brewed this beer, which they have called Purpose Pale Ale, which the purpose is for donating.
That's good. That's good.
To Ales for ALS. On Sunday, they were open on Sunday, which they're not usually. And the other part of this that I wanted to just mention, they opened from noon to 2, which ended up being a little later because they were running late. Stephen Luther, whose father passed away from ALS, is doing a marathon. He wanted to do it all the way across America. His father, back in 1982, ran from San Francisco to Boston in a relay.
Yeah, it's a
with other runners, but they relayed all the way across the country. He's this guy who's from Rochester decided that his father passed away a few years ago now from ALS, wanted to do something for his memory. So this is what he couldn't get enough runners to be able to do the original run, which he still would like to do, but he did one over this past weekend from Rochester to Boston. They were supposed to reach Boston on the 26th.
It's still a long way.
So
I don't know if we're participating in the run.
No,
participating in the beer.
But they were they stopped by on the way. They came by. They came by. Yeah, he came by and spoke.
Like a promotional trail.
Yeah, yeah. He came by. They stopped by a lot of the breweries because Ales for Ales for ALS had got in touch with Wolf Hollow because they knew they were participating. So they stopped by and had.
That's cool.
Some of the guys who weren't running were there.
That's way cool.
And had had a few drinks. And,
yeah, we'll put a picture of that up.
But
I'm thinking I want in on the next. I'll go in on the next one.
Well, Thursday.
Because every dollar goes towards the cause, right?
Yeah. They're releasing this on August 2nd.
I'll give you the money officially. And make sure we have another one.
Yeah. Well, we have a growler tonight.
All right. Well,
so you can try it out, and it is fantastic.
Well, I don't expect anything less from Wolf Hollow.
Right. Well, this is Jordan's first pale ale that they've done.
Yeah.
And it is phenomenal.
Looking for a little slab and pickle.
One of the things I was going to ask you, because I've got two growlers now. My old Brown and Moran and the one from Druthers, you know the size.
Yeah.
I think the volume's different.
Slightly bigger.
What if you show up with one of those?
They don't charge any different. They charge a standard price.
Oh, yeah?
They're only about, I think, maybe 6 ounce difference
than
the other one, so they just charge you the one price.
Oh, that's
so
cool.
Yeah. Because I usually bring one of my old Browns.
Because I've got two. And then I've got these, two growlers that if I...
Yep, so.
Yeah, but you should want to get a...
I do. I definitely want one. Growler. I definitely want a Wolf Hollow growler.
Grrr.
Absolutely.
All right. Well, here we go. Purpose Pale Ale by Wolf Hollow. For a cause.
Oh, I need a sheep. I need a sheep.
Bah, bah.
You don't want the sheep and talent, do you?
What an asshole!
Taste?
Yeah, you should go for
literally
a taste,
just a speck.
This is going to be it's
that's good. I mean, that's literally just a taste.
Yeah, it's on the hoppy side.
I love it.
So I'm going to hop a lot?
Yes.
Yeah, puts a little skip in your step. Episode 80. Just wait for 100, folks. Chew don't know.
Maybe we should make a pact. Do you think we can... Do you think we could have a brew done by 100?
No.
That's 20 episodes away.
Jay could. You couldn't.
That's...
Double it. That's so how many weeks you double it.
40 weeks away. That's...
No, it's actually 38 because you got to take one off from this one.
Yeah.
So it's actually 19. It's
just under a year.
So we got time to make a beer. That's what I'm saying. That's what I'm getting at.
Yeah.
All right, then. That's goal number one. Do I have to write this down? Oh, am I the only one that cares about this?
What's the name of this again?
Purpose Pale Ale.
I'm going to write this down because these guys don't care. They don't give a rat's ass. And then you know what they say at episode 100? Oh, we're just doing the same old show because John didn't follow through with his to-do list.
And we're still waiting for that interview with Pat.
I do have to contact him because there was a cluster. It's a very rare finding.
Yeah, there was a cluster
up at the lake where honeybees were collecting and they keep the queen safe, so there's no nest, no nothing. They need a place to do the honey thing, and they don't. But they don't leave. The problem is, I don't know how a real good beekeeper can collect bees from the wild and start their own honeycomb. You know, and I don't really know how to do that. B, this thing was way up there. Like I had my binoculars to figure out what was going on. Sorry to be distracted from the...
Looking for a little slab and pickle.
So this actually won't come out till August 2nd officially. They're going to open up on a Tuesday, which they're not...
Are we allowed to talk about it?
Yeah. I don't know. We're like talking about it. Right. I don't know. All right. They're not going to arrest me. Maybe they'll ban me from a wolf pack.
Why? You're probably one of their best customers.
How do I become a wolf pack member?
I was surprised that a lot more people didn't show up for this, actually. And... But it was a good cause, and what the hell? Go there and drink beer for a good cause.
Drinking beer, let's get into it.
Is good.
How's the color?
10.
10? Only go to 5. All right. It's a pale ale. It's
10 and a quarter. Because they go to 11.
They go to 11.
He's drinking. I'm not holding back then. I'm drinking. I'm sniffing. I thought you were.
He's smelling.
He's moving to aroma?
Oh, no. He just... Color.
Five. I'm going 5.
Color 5. Aroma. It smells like beer. I don't know. I'm not the connoisseur here.
Get the hop smell.
Yeah.
I like it. I don't know.
I wonder, do they release the information at some point?
Yeah, they actually, if you go on the website, Ales for LS, they tell you the breakdown.
Yeah?
So I think they...
Blend it?
They said... Jordan wasn't there, so I didn't get to get his input on what it was, but Pete said Jordan came up with the recipe based off what the hops
That's
were.
What I was wondering is, and because at that level of brewing, you probably want to know
combinations
to put with the
their hops first pale ale that they've done. They've never done.
Did you pull down that yet?
I pulled down like 10 of them the other day.
Aroma?
I'm getting.
I got to drink some of this.
Well, fuck,
we've already talked about it. Sometimes it enhances
asshole?
The...
It does, definitely.
Well, don't talk about it. Do it.
Oh, that's delicious.
Should be crisp, which it is.
It is.
It is crisp.
You get that crisp taste. That's a pale ale. I mean, it's a...
Did you try it?
I had some before you guys did.
What do you think? I mean, it's good.
Yeah, I could drink a few of these.
It's good.
It is I haven't really had a bad beer there yet.
You what?
You could totally get in the mood
it's
for
a
it.
Great.
Yeah.
Easy to drink.
Yeah. I don't think this is going to make me full.
No. Shouldn't. I mean, it shouldn't. It's not like an IPA.
Yeah, yeah.
It's a little less than that.
It makes it easier for me to enjoy because I like that much is a sip.
So we're back to aroma.
Okay, fine. I thought the aroma is excellent.
I'm at five there. I don't know. To me, it's
yep.
Aroma five.
Okay. Well, we don't know what the numbers are.
Oh, for the alcohol content?
It's 6.4. It's on Untappd already, but I did a photo of the their tap line. Just to
did you do your selfie with it yet?
No.
I'm going to do those later?
Sure.
I'm in.
Yeah, we kind of have to do it together. But yeah, it's 6.4%. So
it's very drinkable.
Mm-hmm. Yep, definitely.
You could definitely pull a bunch of those.
Yeah, yeah. And you know what? The number is not the highest we've seen on the show for sure, but it's a good number for a leisure beer.
Right. Well, I mean, 6.4 is not really anything to sneeze at.
So no, it's a- not at all.
Looking for a little slab and pickle.
That'll get you there fast enough. So alcohol content?
I like where it's at.
I'm five all day on this. So.
Yeah, okay.
You don't have to.
Alcohol content,
I'm just waiting at what you think. I mean,
flavor.
I love it.
An honest opinion.
I love it. Makes me, and it feels good.
Let's just call this flavor.
You brought five. A couple that have been delicious. I was getting full sometimes. It's one of the reasons why I go light.
Brewery, size, and location.
Yeah.
Five. Well, it's a five overall. Know, five.
I mean, to me, I mean, I don't know what John thinks, but.
Yeah. No,
I'm all fives on this all day. I mean, you can't beat the freshness, is what
I know.
I think it pretty much was said when he took that first pull on it, went delicious.
Forget about it.
I mean, it's a great beer and it's a great cause. I mean,
we're in.
Yeah.
It comes out again August 2nd. Officially.
So if we take this and we go, ready?
What?
On three.
What?
And just do that. Right?
Okay.
Ready?
Okay, I know where you're going. For real, though? Yeah. You want to throw it?
No, not for, don't really throw it, but just make the motion.
I see.
On three. Yeah. One, two, three. There it is. Yeah.
There it is.
Look at that. Magic.
Yeah, yeah.
Magic.
That's but, right. And yeah. Right about now, I'll go, it's gone.
Can you... do both sides because it does have the information.
That's right. I brought two, so hopefully you could.
Yeah, I'll take pictures of both sides.
Yeah, that way they.
I'll probably put. I'll. You'll see it up there before that one. Yep. But that'll be back.
Cool. But yeah, cool. Ales for ALS. Alesforals.com.
And you know, this makes me feel really good too because I don't participate on the Facebook challenges.
You're interruptus biggest dickest tonight.
Just because these things are. I'm sorry. Go ahead.
No.
I get to participate, and I've wanted to, but I didn't want to do the bucket challenge. It was like it was like tattoos to me. Everybody else is doing it. That doesn't mean I do it. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
This is cool, totally different. I get to support the cause, and it's not because it's what everybody's doing. It falls into our wheelhouse.
Do it.
Right.
Do
that's,
it.
So
do
I, it. And that's why I did it. I mean, it was easy for me to do. It.
Yeah, exactly. So
it's very one, enjoyable for you
of,
to do.
One of two things that I like to do.
Yeah.
Not running.
Hey, but I do have a lot of folks at work. Some listen. Who are serious about running that might be interested.
So what's the other thing you like to do?
Well, maybe three things. But, you know, Ales for ALS is the one website, and then ALSRelayAcrossAmerica.com is the other one. That's for Stephen Luther and the Gang of Runners, which I respect the hell out of them, man. That's any kind of running they can do, and they're doing it hardcore, and they're doing it for a good reason.
And it's at www.alesforals.com and what's the hell I want to say?
Instagram.
They have an ALS Instagram page, Ales for ALS Instagram page, and hashtag Ales for ALS.
Yep. And then just to throw another plug out there for this Stephen Luther who did this relay, ALSRelayAcrossAmerica.com. He lost his everybody that was participating in the relay had a family member or a close friend that passed away from ALS. So it was a good cause, you know, to get a little serious. But and that's something easy to do, go down to Wolf Hollow starting August 2nd, and they're donating $1 for every pint they sell. They're filling growlers, donating all that money to ALS research. So,
nice.
You know,
So go down to Wolf's Hollow Brewing Company on Route 5 in West Glenville.
Yep, and they're going to be open special on Tuesday, August 2nd. They're not usually open on Tuesdays from 5 to 10 for a special release party for this beer that we're already drinking.
Which is delicious.
It's fantastic beer.
Fantastic.
As all their other beers.
Yeah.
And great food.
So. They haven't given me... Oh, I haven't done the food yet there. I got to get it over there. Chillin' with Jay's Brew. Chillin' with Jay's Brew.
In the fall.
Chillin' with Jay's Brew.
In your face, all over the place. We're online 24/7. 24/7. You're listening to the hottest internet station.
Bob and John, super duper variety power.
Finger painting?
Yeah, they're 1 year.
All right, you primitive screwheads, listen up.
Time to make the chimmy fucking changas.
You can find us at bobandjohnspodcast@gmail.com. On iTunes and Buzzsprout.com or
at Loose and Buttery on the Twitter and Instagram or Periscope.
And on our YouTube channel on our Facebook page at Bob and John's Super Duper Variety Power Hour. Also on Untapped at Jay's Brew and Brewmaster Pick with two C's.
We should do this on Thursday. Sounds like fun.
What's that?
Their anniversary. They've been there a year already.
Their year.
But not
their
really 1 year
anniversary at their new location.
Felt like we were just talking about.
They're setting out a new location. Beer.
Yeah, they just them moving there.
Just the moving there. Yeah.
On Thursday? This Thursday?
We're going. Yep. 4:15. Damn. And they're introducing a new beer, a Schwartz beer.
There's a day off, John, right there.
Call it in. Mm-hmm. I should have taken this week off, but. Was the plan. Let's not worry about it.
Call in and tell you have biggest dickus.
I'm having biggest dickus. Excuse me?
I'm having biggest dickus today. And then he'll get in his lederhosen and come down.
And I'm all alone. I wear my lederhosen.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 1, 1, 1. We have ignition. Strap in. You're about to listen to
with Bob and John.
And Jay.
What an asshole!
When I hit that wooden asshole was for the talent thing. It sounded like I just like, and Jay, what an asshole.
He is.
You are. We went double talent on your ass there. Yeah. Everybody
Ouch.
Did.
Ouch.
What an asshole.
Dear God. It becomes fisting after a while.
That's all. That's where we're headed. That's all. That's why.
What an asshole. See, there's a big circle right there.
That's how this happened. It slowly turned into.
just do it.
Fist pump.
Oh, fist dear pump God. John's been hanging out the Blythewood too long. Too much.
Egg along gone.
All right, our top 10. This week is...
The thing that always made me crazy is it was built like 2 steps away from the sawmill, which is a biker bar.
And look how friendly the communities were.
I know. They lived happily together. Yeah, they were totally fine.
Looking for a little slap and pickle.
Our top 10 this week is top 10 track ones or like first songs on an album. It was hard to like get the right explanation, especially when you're texting it to make it. But so, I mean, obviously, I mean, I went through list and list and list, and some of it I found is somewhat fucking dribble bullshit, you know.
What a fucking.
Yeah, there's a lot critical of critical lists for this.
Critical
there.
Acclaim bullshit. Yeah. It's like, really? Never even fucking heard of that album? Yeah.
If I didn't hear about it, I didn't use it.
Yeah, right. Exactly.
Right.
I went purely by what I, what my right. opinion is.
Right. You should be songs that you liked.
Yeah.
That were.
Or at least familiar
number
with.
One, right. Yeah. It happened to be number ones.
I had a hard time not taking 50% of Led Zeppelin's albums.
I kept it to one Zeppelin.
I did too. That's what I decided to do because I could have easily used five to six on Zeppelin.
Yeah, right. But
I tried to pick my favorite Zeppelin one. That's what
yeah, yeah. I mean, some of them. Listen, I love Houses of the Holy, but Song Remains the Same is not one of my. I wouldn't. There's a lot of other bands that have better number one songs on an album than Song Remains the Same. That's not saying Song Remains the Same is not one of my favorite songs, but you know what I mean? You can't have every Zeppelin song on there.
Nah, that's why I didn't do the bunch of them. Tried to get different bands.
Who wants to start?
I'm going.
All right. Number 10.
And you know I'm not a huge fan of these folks, but it is a huge song by a huge band. I went with number 10, Come Together, Beatles.
That didn't make my list, but it was on. You know why it didn't make my list? Because I'm just tired of the song.
Yeah, yeah.
I'm just tired of the song. Yeah. It's a great song.
I never over-listened to it. I never did.
Between that version.
When it pops up, I appreciate it.
Between is a great song. I'm not a huge fan.
Yeah. Between that version and Aerosmith's version, both being great versions, I just got overdone with it.
I never.
I like the song. I just. Oh, it's over. It's just. Yeah, I need to stay away.
Because the way Aerosmith did it, though, made me appreciate where the Beatles were.
They didn't really do too much to it, actually.
No, that's what I'm saying.
Yeah,
it seemed a little ahead of its time. You know what I mean? And I have to throw
Beatles
some
were
kudos.
Always. You know.
Yeah. No. Of course. That's why they were good.
Paving like, the way. You know what I mean?
So I mean, I have to. I guess I was just throwing out my kudos for the. You know, I'm not a giant Beatles fan. I'm really not.
Yeah. No.
But, do you like little Beatles?
No. No. All Beatles actually bug the shit out of me. June bugs? Oh my God, that's a beetle, and that's you. Did you ever?
Yes.
Did you ever have lots of hair and have a June bug end up in it? It's frightening.
Jay, you're number 10 before he gets going.
I won't elaborate. I'll try and keep. Try and stop it. All right. Oh God, I'm gonna go with. Give Me Shelter by the Rolling Stones.
That's a good one.
Yeah, that is a good one. That is a good one.
Off of Let It Bleed, 1969.
Yeah. It was on my honorable mention.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
On that. My number 10.
But I don't screw myself.
That's what happens when you go on a slide.
If you screw yourself, you got talent.
Yeah, that's right.
What an asshole!
My number 10, I'm, you know what? I'm going pretty new. I'm going Elevate by the Winery Dogs.
Wow. Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Because it's one of my all time favorite songs now. And it's a number one.
It's a good song.
So that's where I'm
that's
going
a good one.
Yeah. And I actually didn't look at a lot of new stuff, but
I didn't either. And I like that one
yeah.
a lot. But for my number 9 happens to be Give Me Shelter by the Stones.
All right.
Yeah, we're in the sorry.
All right.
So we were in the ballpark there. Right. I like that one. There's, you know, I'm not a huge Stones fan. Right. I'm really
I put that on my big list, but the one that got bumped out by Elevate was a Stones song. Brown Sugar. Brown Sugar is another
I
one
love
too.
Brown Sugar mm-hmm. too. Yeah. I do. I think what happened to me on that one is Give Me Shelter was on more lists that I looked at than you know what I mean.
I just want to. Sometimes I like to go through the list just to see that I'm not. I like to make my list first, then look at other lists to see that I'm really not forgetting a major thing.
Yeah.
So that yeah, but I like Brown Sugar as a song better than Give Me Shelter.
It is. See, I wasn't sure that was the first song on the album.
Yeah. Number 9, Jay?
9 to me. I'm going to go with Give Me All Your Lovin' by ZZ Top.
Oh, that's a good one. That's a good one.
That is. Yeah, I was surprised that was actually was number one off Eliminator 1983.
We play that.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Except we play it with Give Me a Bran Muffin and a Dozen and a Donuts, dozen too. It's terrible. When we play that at band practice, I that's how I sing it because I automatically go into that thanks to our bass player.
Good going.
Yeah.
Good
going. I like that song. And
yeah.
That was easy tough.
I did not. I that one to slipped by me. In there.
Yeah. And yeah, actually, they had Sleeping Bag off of Afterburner, too.
So oh, yeah.
That was the
another, I went out of my song. I went out of my wheelhouse for sure. I miss.
But
on my list, I mean,
my number nine is Slide It In, Whitesnake.
Ooh, you nasty motherfucker!
Damn, really? Nasty.
Oh yeah,
it's a pretty good song.
It's fucking. It's a great album.
I love that song. Huh. Yeah, it is.
You what?
I didn't know it was number one.
Yeah.
Wow.
That's a good. That
slid by me.
That's a great one.
Yeah,
that's a great
that's,
one.
That song. Starts off that whole album.
Hmm. Oh, it didn't wasn't Connie. Tawny Katane in that video? Is that the one?
No. She was. It was the next album they did, which was like Here I Go Again
on My Own.
Yeah, that's the what they call the 87 album because it was just labeled Whitesnake.
Yeah,
that album it has. That's when
Slide
he was married.
In, that was better.
Oh, Slide It In was a lot better album.
Yeah.
Slide It In was that's what I call the. White Snake's pinnacle album.
I'm driving around with that pumping in the car.
The whole first track to last track. Play the whole damn thing. It's awesome.
Well, shit. At one time though, I thought Skid Row was that great.
Skid Row's album still good.
Yeah, it has
it's
some
still,
great
it's
stuff.
Still really good.
Yeah.
That album. Yeah. Near number eight.
Mine.
Yeah.
Here's where I just said out loud. I'm going out, but. Big picture of things, I took it. Let's Go Crazy, Prince.
Yeah, why not?
Yeah, absolutely. You run across it in a little, multiple genres. It's not
some of mine. I ran into problems because I have mixes on my iTunes, so I don't have albums. And I remember seeing Prince, and I wanted to go back and check Prince's stuff, and I didn't.
My favorite liquor store that I go to, always. Has a good station on, and a lot of times Michael Jackson's playing. And again, I'm not a huge Michael Jackson fan. It's like not the type of music I would play. But man, through the years, he just had a lot of good music.
Oh yeah, he had a lot of good hits.
You know what I mean? He just
good
had
songs,
a lot
good
of
song,
good music.
Whether you like it or not,
yeah. Find yourself Prince, moonwalking I was, across the floor.
Yeah, that's fantastic.
Michael Jackson.
I tried
a lot
that
of good
shit.
Stuff.
Broke my toe.
I was more of a Prince. I was more of a Prince person. I
Prince
thought he had a lot
is pretty
better
classic,
stuff.
And yeah. We lost him. This year,
mm-hmm.
So
yeah, and you're not going to find them.
No,
maybe someday.
Yeah,
no, they keep finding Elvis, which is crazy.
Let's Go Crazy. That's definitely a good one. I have on there. Your number eight, Jay.
I'm going. I'm going with Kielbasa.
He said,
"Talent."
What an asshole!
He said, "Kielbasa"
from Tenacious D.
Oh, it's great!
I
song.
Looked at that. Actually, heard this on the way out here. This was one
that's
of the ones.
Great.
I
have that album. That's an awesome album.
It's a great album. I love those guys, and had to get it in there.
That's an awesome
had to get
album.
The Kielbasa in there.
The Kielbasa.
Love it. Never mind.
From the album Tenacious D in 2001.
Yeah, that is their best one too.
Yep. Great stuff.
Now, this is my number eight was one that I'm actually is probably one of my least favorite on the album, but it is a great number one song on the album that shows you how good the album is. My number eight is Welcome to the Jungle.
I went number seven, Welcome to the Jungle.
All right.
Had to be in there. I mean, it was what sucked me in at the time. Over the years, I lost a little interest in Guns, but
actually,
that album, Jesus,
that
I was
album,
hook, line, and sinker.
Actually, I found Welcome to the Jungle. I got sucked in differently and then found Welcome to the Jungle. I got introduced to them acoustically, if you believe that. They were doing an acoustic thing on Arsenio Hall, and they were doing You're Crazy acoustically.
See,
and I was like,
I've been telling you, I think we might be on.
That's how I got. And then all of a sudden, and then I borrowed Tom Gray's tape.
Wise,
lost his tape.
Oh, you pulled a Steve?
I paid for, I gave, I
Keep it up. You put the fork. You let it go.
I'm trying. It's not working. I've been trying to do a Jedi mind trick for the last 5 minutes, but it's not working.
I rebought. No. Unlike Steve, I rebought him the tape.
See? That's why you're my buddy. You know how to handle shit.
I put it on top of my of the Pinot when my father was driving the Pinot to work, and he went to work the next day that summer. Yeah, he had gone.
It was an accident. You didn't steal it.
No, I didn't.
Steve stole my shit, and he didn't replace it.
Steve stole your shit?
Yeah.
Does he have talent?
Yeah, he's got talent.
What an asshole!
Hey, we were talking about the other day, and I don't want to get into details, but it's the sort of thing where, like, yeah, it might just be shit. But it's my fucking shit. Leave it alone.
This is not going well.
Looking for a little slapping pickle.
A little slapping pickle. I was just looking for a little slapping pickle.
So my 8 was welcome to the jungle. Your 7 was welcome to the jungle.
Yep.
So that brings it right around.
I'll round it out with welcome to the jungle.
Oh, look at that. Hey.
I was surprised that was that low for you guys, to be honest.
Yeah.
It's one of the. It ranks up with one of those. It ranks up there with. What song did you say that I was like, I can't listen to anymore? You guys put, we were just talking.
Right.
About.
Yeah.
It's,
Yeah.
I don't
remember either.
There's so much good stuff on that album.
Right.
That
Come Together, you were talking about.
Come Together. It's kind of in that realm for me where I'm like, I get bored when it comes up, I'll listen to it or something, but if I can switch to something else. I do. Yeah. If there's something else on, I'd rather listen to something else because I've heard it a million. I know how to play it on guitar. I've heard it a million times.
Yep. Yeah, I've heard it a million times too.
Yeah, that's the only problem sometimes with track ones, like, is that you've heard them a billion times.
I know. Like that album, I think I might go Mr. Brownstone for best song, my favorite song.
Over Rocket Queen?
Well, Rocket Queen's pretty good too. That's
see,
tough
there's
one.
It's yeah, way tough.
That's a tough
Out
one.
To Get Me, Night Train, My Michelle. You're crazy. Anything Goes. Sweet Child of Mine, for God's sake. You know what I mean?
I'm still.
It's the whole I would be album. Between I think I just two. Named the whole fucking album.
It's good.
It's so easy.
Did we? Have we done that? Have we done a full top 10?
Guns?
No.
Top 10. What?
Like.
Best front song to, on
front,
an album?
No, front to back, greatest album.
Gotcha.
I don't know.
Yeah.
I don't know if we've done that.
I don't know if we've done that.
I'm not sure. That would be a challenge.
Put our interns on that.
Yeah,
put our interns on that. Get to that, guys.
Okay.
Yeah.
We'll give you beer next time.
I'll give you beer next time.
Will I say the name? Because.
Almost hurts to do that.
So welcome to the jungle, 7.
So
I'm at 7, aren't I?
7.
That's 7.
7 for me is More Than a Feeling, Boston.
Oh.
You can't go wrong with that. I mean,
it's on my list.
It's in there.
That's another album where I'm not so worn out with that song, but another one where the album that would be on my list with Slide It In and Appetite for Destruction of albums you can just put on.
I love Boston.
I wish I knew that when we were playing earlier in life. I didn't know you were such a Boston fan.
Huge Boston fan.
We had a singer that could hit that shit.
Nope, there goes.
Oh, you scab puller.
No, I didn't. I was just itching and now it's gone.
Talent.
How is it?
What looks okay. Asshole!
Fine.
No How's your other scab? Oh, there.
It's still kind of covered up there. This see is the that. Longest that I've had a bandage on it.
Hmm.
Taking showers with it like that and everything, it just kind of stays there. So I'm like, fuck it.
You're but number 6. Fuck
it's
it.
Almost gone. It's doing good considering it was a second degree burn. Number 7.
6.
Number 6.
Looking for a little slap and pickle.
Looking for a little slap and pickle.
Yeah.
Slap and pickle. number 7.
6.
Yeah, I know. I was just messing with you. Running with the Devil.
Yes.
Had a big part. Yeah, I... You know,
it's one of those one. It's like an epic opening song.
Yeah, it was the
like Welcome to the Jungle
life when it came out and stuff. Yeah, you know, it's just good timing.
Oh, that's well. Again, we talk about another album that you can listen forward and backwards to.
Yeah, exactly. There's a lot of good ones on that one.
Yeah, amazing ones on that one.
Yeah, I'm going same place with that one.
All right.
So I wanted to get it on there, and yeah, it would have probably gone higher, but I listened to it a lot. It was our high school theme song. So
oh, was it?
This beer is good,
Blue
man.
Blue Devils.
Oh, was it? Yeah, I didn't know that.
It made me sick of the song, but it was a great song. But at the same time, made me sick of it because I heard it like all the time.
But. Yeah, when I think I saw Sammy at what do you call it there? The one out by Buffalo. Not it's like just like Spac.
Oh, yeah.
Darien Lake.
Darien Lake.
Oh. Saw Sammy out there at Darien Lake, and they did like that's when Michael Anthony was first starting to tour with him and stuff. Yeah. And he came out and sang.
I was supposed to go. I didn't go.
Yeah.
Told me about all the fun I missed.
Took John a few times to get him to Sammy, but we finally did.
Yep. Finally got to Sammy. Finally got to Kid. Kid was the same problem. They didn't come east. Mm. You know what I mean? They didn't come to Spac until recently. Mm-hmm. This year he doesn't have a new album, so he didn't come. But prior to that, two summers in a row he came. But before that, never.
Did he come to us?
I'm sure.
Looking for a little slab and pickle.
I know how the slab and pickle goes.
My number six is not Running with the Devil. It's Babel O'Reilly off of The Who's mm-hmm. Who's Next.
God bless you.
Yep.
Which is another killer album. It's funny how a lot of these
I wish I
songs.
Could...
Oh,
that's
did.
The worst one ever. Oh, that was the worst one ever. Oh, yeah. Shut up! Yeah, that's the worst one ever.
Oh.
Mm-hmm. Well, we can't ruin this show now.
Oh, no.
Well, you just did, didn't you?
No, I did not. I used to have towels around here for such things.
You used to have a mung rag, too. Yeah. Shit. You're
looking for a little slab and pickle.
Oh, we'll take care of it.
Wet feet.
Is it going over there?
No.
I was going to
say,
no.
You have wet feet.
No, yeah, no, I'm bathed in beer.
Well, okay, John.
Sounds like a hot item, Bob.
Well, that sounds like a hot item.
Oh, we.
Number five?
Don't ruin my book.
Can you read it?
Yeah. Number five, it up. I went with Hell's Bells.
Excellent. That's a good one.
Right. Yeah. I think AC/DC had to be in there.
Yeah. Oh,
I think that was introduction to...
I have two AC/DCs, one on the also mentions and one on my list.
Oh.
But another album back and forth you can listen to. Number five, Jay?
Shine On You Crazy Diamond, Pink Floyd.
Ooh, you part know. 1 through 5?
Yes. I through V.
I through V? 1 through 5?
Yes, from great, Wish You Were Here.
Yeah, that's a great opening. That's just a great song.
I was gonna use that one too.
It's on my honorable mention.
Yeah.
My number five is Running with the Devil.
Aha, see nice. That? Right. Same number.
No, you had six.
Running with the Devil. Oh yeah, you're right.
You and Jay had it at six.
Six.
That's close enough. Oh, there it goes.
Your pages are in my book.
Sticky pages.
Gonna need some work here.
John, you're number four. We'll try to move this along faster.
Did I do? What was?
Did you leave four out?
No, I've got it.
Okay.
How did that happen? Yeah. Did I say More Than a Feeling already?
No.
Oh, okay. That's what I took. Number four. Oh. All right. That's what I went for. Number four.
Yeah.
Yep.
Jay.
More Than a Feeling.
Ooh, oh, look at that! Yeah.
We had Welcome to the Jungle and.
Yeah.
Running with the Devil.
Definitely. Great song.
My number four is, here's the AC/DC, Highway to Hell, though.
I'm on a highway to hell.
Which I think Back in Black's a better album, but I like the song Highway to Hell better than Hell's Bells.
All right. Well, that philosophy makes sense.
You're number three?
Mine?
Yes. And I'm partial to it because we play it.
So. I went with War Pigs.
That was on my that made the honorable mention list.
Black Sabbath from Black Sabbath was a huge list one.
Not one of my favorites, though.
But I was more into War Pigs.
Oh, absolutely! Yeah. If I got to pick a Sabbath one, it's going to be War Pigs.
Yeah.
That was high. That was if we had a top 20 list, that'd be like number 11, 12 in there. Jay, you're number what? Where are you at?
Three. I'm going with Hell's Bells.
There you go. Nice.
Uh-huh.
Yep.
My number three, my three, two, and one are my top three favorite bands, so I just had to put them in the correct order. Three is Back in the Saddle off of Rocks.
Ah.
I mean, talk about an opening song.
Mm-hmm. That's good.
You know, Back in the Saddle again.
That's a good one.
Ludovero Smith.
Yeah.
Your number two?
I went, and this is the one I chose out of all the other ones. Chose it over Immigrant Song. Chose it over Songs Remain the Same. Chose it over Whole Lot of Love. I took Black Dog.
Oh, that was your Zeppelin. Huh?
Yeah, that was my Zeppelin.
There you go.
That was my Zeppelin pick.
Yeah, I had that one. It came down to two for Zeppelin for me, which I won't reveal until it's time.
Okay, well, it's your prerogative.
But that was one of the two. I won't say which one made it.
All right.
You're number two, Jay?
I'm going with...
You know, the funny thing is, not to interrupt you since Jay's thinking.
Yeah, I'm thinking.
I had to go back and look at that because... They used to open up with rock and roll, mm-hmm. and as a band, we've opened up with rock and roll.
Yeah.
So at first, I'm like, "Oh, rock and roll!" And then I had to go, "Is that?" And then I had to go back and look at the actual album because I was like, "Oh no, it's not the opener."
Yeah. No dice. Otherwise, that would have probably been.
Yeah. Yeah, that was a little tricky for me. Your number two, Jay.
Black Dog.
That's a good one.
Yep.
Nice
Black Dog.
And you introduced me to.
Well, that's what I was going to say. Because of the Dred Zeppelin version of that was on my big list.
Hey, mama, said the way you move. That's good stuff, though.
Love those guys.
I enjoyed it.
My number two is not Zeppelin. And my number two is Detroit Rock City with Kiss.
Got it.
Off a Destroyer.
You don't always, I've noticed.
What?
With some lists, I feel like you always are going to have a Kiss because it's one of your favorite bands, but you don't always.
It depends on the list.
I know.
This list was really more geared. I geared it solely toward what I know and what I like.
Yeah.
So,
yeah.
I obviously Kiss is going to be very high on my list with Detroit Rock City.
Nice.
So, and your number one there, Saggy Book.
Sloppy shoes.
Soggy. Yeah, if I don't move soon, I'm going to get stuck here forever. I think this has a little bit to do with a few of the YouTube videos I've been watching recently.
I can't even imagine. We can't even imagine what would be your number one if it's not Zeppelin.
I know. I went with "We Will Rock You" by Queen.
Wow, I feel that was a number one.
I feel it's it being just super influential across so many platforms. Yeah. I guess.
Yeah, I didn't even see that on the list. So,
yeah, I'm on a Queen kick recently. It might have something to do with it.
Hey, okay, that's still Jay. Your number one.
The candidates are using it. I mean, you know what I mean? It's used.
And getting told not to use it.
So many things. It's fucking crazy.
Only because it's their first album. I'm going with Good Times, Bad Times.
Oh, that's a good one. I love that
right
one.
Right here.
I love that.
Good Times,
Bad Times.
There
you go. Look at that. Winner, chicken dinner.
It's their first album. I love the Zeppelin. And
I saw on one of the lists, the guy put it perfectly. Zeppelin, you could have put just about any Zeppelin album on there, track number one for number one.
Oh, right, yeah.
Right. But Good Times, Bad Times in one song shows you everything of what Zeppelin is about.
Yeah.
I'm just looking at John's puddle.
Looking for a little slap and pickle.
The things I go through for this show.
That's talent.
That's right.
Talent.
I got a lot of talent.
What
I'll tell you that right now. Man.
Here, we'll end the top 10.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 1, 1.
Stick off.
We have ignition. Strap in.
You're about to listen to
John getting unstuck.
My book's pulling apart.
Your
now.
Book.
All right, you primitive screwheads, listen up.
Time to make the chimmy fucking chongas.
You can find us at bobandjohnspodcast@gmail.com, on iTunes and buzzsprout.com, or
at Loose and Buttery on the Twitter and Instagram or Periscope.
And on our YouTube channel and our Facebook page at Bob and John Super Duper Variety Power Hour. And also at johnstucktothefloor.com.
Yeah, I know. I am.
And on Untapped, Jay's Brew and
Jiminy Brewmaster.
Looking for a little slab and pickle.
When I say the name.
Stickus? Biggest stickus.
Stickus?
That's how I feel like that's Jay looking at you. He's trying to hold it in so bad.
Because right. He can see the puddle.
Wow. We haven't done a short one like this in a while.
Really?
Hour and 10 minutes.
I'm distracted.
Yeah, really. I think we sped a, things we up.
I'm heavily distracted. I'm sticky everywhere.
Say goodnight, stickies.
Goodnight, sticky.
Goodnight, sticky.
Stadler?
Yeah, what?
Is that it?
Yes, it's over. How'd you like it?
I don't know. I slept through the whole thing.
Why? I didn't miss much.
Chico! When I say the name, because...
Looking for a little slab and pickle.